Norm, I'm sorry about what I said about your gravy.
All right.
It's okay.
Fine.
And so are the carrots.
Anybody want some of these lovely yams? Woody, would you care to test the gravy skin?
So, I want you to imagine something. Well, let me start off by saying this. I'm talking about turkey today. If you are not a turkey person, I want you to substitute in turkey for anything else, or substitute something in for turkey. So whether it's ham, seafood, whatever is your Thanksgiving deal, your big deal, just play along. And this is mainly for my family because I know they hate turkey. So here we go. Imagine, close your eyes, and pretend you're walking into your house for Thanksgiving, and you know there's being turkey cooked. If your house is cooking a turkey, you can smell it. You can smell it for hours, and it smells wonderful. And you know that whoever is preparing the feast, mom or dad, whoever, has already got it on the table. You walk into the house, you smell that turkey, and you turn the corner to go into the living room, and there it is, the turkey. And that's it. Sure, there's plates, but it's just a turkey sitting there all by itself. You might be okay, but realistically, in your head, if you're like most people, you're like, well, where's the mashed potatoes? Where's the green beans? Where's the gravy? Where's the sweet potato casserole? Where is the candied sweet potatoes? Where's the cranberry sauce? Where's the cranberry sauce? Where are the rolls? Where's all the good stuff that goes with the turkey? And that's what we're going to talk about today. All the good stuff that goes with the turkey. Now, we call those side dishes. And I've polled a lot of people recently just to see what their favorite side dishes are. Most people tend to... Well, before I limited desserts, most people were going with pie. Like a pumpkin pie kind of deal. Because that's a quintessential Thanksgiving item. But a lot of folks went to the potato variety, whether it's mashed potatoes or sweet potato casserole, or I just had a conversation with Robert about his grandmother's candied sweet potatoes, which honestly sounded really delicious. Personally, I have a non-fan favorite item. I really love cranberry sauce to the point where I'm pretty much the only one that eats it, so I'm in charge of making it. So I make at least two different varieties of it every year and bring them because it's my thing. It's just what I do at this point. The interesting thing about side dishes is that everybody likes different ones. And pretty much that's okay. It's universally okay to not like the green beans. In fact, telling on my sister here for a minute, my sister hated every conventional Thanksgiving dish. She hated green beans, and she hated mashed potatoes. And can I just say that Thanksgivings were a delight to watch her be forced to eat this food? Thank you, Sarah, for years of entertainment with that one. Anyway, everybody has their own thing, and that's perfectly okay. Now, you ready for the metaphor? Here we go. In the grand scheme of things, Thanksgiving dinner is not that important. What is important in the grand scheme of things is us being in relationship with Christ. And many times we have heard that it's a table. Christ has set a table for us. And there's always a spot for everybody. There's a spot for everybody. And if we were to apply a metaphor to this situation, the turkey is the main reason we have this big meal. It's the centerpiece. Without it, what's kind of the point? And Christ is our turkey in this sense. I know this is really off, going off the hinges here. Christ is the turkey. He's the whole reason we are there. He's the He provides this. He provides Himself as an avenue for this. What we have, though, is that on an earthly level, not spiritually, on an earthly level, just Christ, while it is enough, and we can sustain ourselves on Christ alone, make no mistake, it's not as flavorful if we don't have other people coming along with us. If we don't have other people bringing the side dishes. We are meant to come together as a family, as a Christian family, as an earthly family as well. But we are meant to come together and each bring our own special flavor to the table. Because let's be honest, you ever been to a Thanksgiving dinner where somebody brought some side dish, you had no idea what it was, but it was amazing? In fact, that was my my real kick off the deep end into the cranberry sauce was my aunt in South Carolina made this really awesome cranberry relish. I'm like, that's amazing. I never had it, but I'm going to keep eating it like forever. So that's one of the things I make every year. Thanks, Aunt Mary Ellen. And but that's what people are to the situation. We all need Christ. We all crave, well, we should crave, that main dish. Because without it, we can't sustain ourselves. But we need people to come to the table as well. Yes, we could do it alone, but no, we are not meant to do it alone. Christ has a table set for us with many seats. Imagine being told there was a party that was going to be great, and you show up and it's just you and one other person. It's not as fun, is it? Well, it suits the needs. It's not as good. I want you to think about that this year, is that we are, Christ has this table set for us, but there are all different sorts of manner and types of people that need to come to the table as well. He's not restricting it for anybody. There are no restrictions on Christ, nor should we restrict other people from approaching the table as well. This is an open table for all to enjoy. Please think about that. This is all of us, because there's so much division right now in our world that we need to get that out of our head. Of all the things that we should agree upon, is that Christ is the reason for what we do, and there should be no other reason besides that. Have a great week. It's Thanksgiving is just around the corner. Better start thinking about what kind of dishes you're going to prepare, because even if you're just attending a party, you're still expected to bring something. Bye. Have a good week.